What is it about an over-the-hill mid-table championship player on high wages that's never won anything in his career that just makes Rangers Football Club drop to their knees and throw everything their way? Well, I don't know what it is, but welcome back to Fog Football, and I'm going to absolutely bash this potential signing here for Kenny McLean to Rangers. I don't care if he's a Rangers man, all right? I'm actually seeing people on Twitter saying, oh, this would be a fantastic sign. How would this be a fantastic signing, by the way? To me, this is just a guy that's on like a Tom Lawrence sort of guy. I do not grasp why this signing would be any good for Rangers. I think this is the sort of signing the Rangers need to steer away from. A guy that's on too high of wages from the English Championship, that's never really done anything and isn't going to do anything. The only thing I will give Kenny McLean is that he never gets injury prone.
Which is something you can't say about a lot of Rangers players, to be honest.
You can't say about a lot of Rangers players. If you watched our player ratings, this guy absolutely stunk the joint out against Hungary as Scotland crashed out of the Euros. And I'm not going to, you know, blast a guy on that, right? But this guy's been done for a couple of years for me. He always sneaks in the back door for Scotland squads. I've never seen him actually do anything for Norwich. Why do Rangers fans want this guy? I'm fucking cute. They're throwing in Grant Hanley as well. Oh, if we did a double swoop for these guys, it'd be here, give me Grant Hanley every day of the week over Kenny McLean. Kenny McLean? Why? Why would Rangers take... Is it because he's an actual Rangers fan? Which, by the way, he must keep that in the closet, because if Steve Clarke got a sniff of that...
Yeah, I don't think
he'd be nowhere near the team.
He wouldn't be one of his favourites, that is for sure. But yeah, Kenny McLean then, linked with Rangers. It just seems like a bizarre move to me.
Daily Record, everywhere reporting on it now. His current market value is 900,000. He has peaked before at, what, 4.5 million, which was about 4.5 years ago when he was 27. He is 32, all right? The rumour is Rangers would have to pay between 1.5 and 2 million for a guy that's got 2 years left on his deal. But he's 32, man. The guy's 32 years of age. He'll be 33 in January.
I mean, if he's a good player, you could argue that you've got a few more good years of Kenny McLean, but I just don't think he is. I think he's very overrated. I've never been impressed with Kenny McLean. I've never watched him play for Scotland, and I could never really understood why he kept getting picked by Steve Clarke, to be honest.
He's got 41 caps for Scotland.
And he hasn't impressed me in any of them.
Apart from that Norway game.
Yeah, well, that was a good goal. I will give him credit for that. I'm grateful for that. Thank God he scored that. But other than that, I mean, there really has not been much for Kenny McLean. Anytime I've seen him play at a club level, I haven't really seen much. And I mean, I don't necessarily think it's a bad signing if Rangers get it through the door across the line, but it's just not, it's not really the signing you want, like, into that. It's not filling you with optimism.
No, it's not. I think there's just other way better players that if you are going to go for the aging category bracket, then I think you can just get better players than Kenny McLean.
Yeah, it's like, you may as well just keep Ryan Jack, in my opinion, if you're going to get Kenny McLean. Although you could argue Kenny McLean, unlike Ryan Jack, can actually stay fully fit.
Well, yeah, that is the only plus side that I would actually give to Kenny McLean. He does stay incredibly fit. He pretty much played every game last season for... he did. He played every single game in the Championship. 100% in the starting 11. He did 99% of the minutes. He got one goal and five assists. I mean, I've kind of already went over his stats on my channel, but as for this channel, I mean... Here... The problem for me is I just think that in a year, 2 years' time, we'll be sitting here saying, oh, we need to get this guy off the wage bill. We shouldn't have signed him. I just think it's another Tom Lawrence in disguise without the injury record that Tom Lawrence does possess, because I look at Kenny McLean, it's like his days are numbered with the Scotland team. I think he's probably played his last game.
Very possible.
Especially if Clarke goes...
I mean, he's 32. By the time we rock up for the World Cup, he will be 34. I think he's at the
Are
point...
Are we rocking up for the World
well,
Cup?
Well, probably way? Not. So, I mean, you could look at it by the next time we're rocking up for him. He'll be like 36. I think Kenny McLean should be getting phased out of... I think he should be getting phased out of the Scotland setup. And it's the same thing, I mean, with Rangers. If he was a Rangers player, then by all means, you know, but I don't think he's the kind of guy that they should be looking to sign. It just seems like a weird signing. It's just not one that...
Especially a couple of mil. Rangers have all been linked this summer with youngsters. Up-and-coming talent. Exciting talent. Kenny McLean's not exciting. It's like no, he's not. It's like you're losing Ryan Jack and you're bringing in a guy that's just like...
Just kind of like Ryan Jack, but only fit.
Aye. Which, yeah, some people would argue is fantastic. But for me, if I was to rate this signing out of 10,
I'd say it's like a 5.
I'd give it a 4. It makes no sense for me. I think Rangers should stay well clear of it. At least like Connor Barron, young, exciting talent. I mean, even though I'm not too happy, I think he will. Connor Barron. I don't rate the guy. I said he's Scott Wright 2.0. Well, who the fuck's this guy then?
Is Kenny McLean really the guy you want to see in the starting 11? Like, when Rangers are taking on Celtic next season, Old Firm, is Kenny McLean the guy that you want to see when that team gets picked? I think he's a squad player, like, for Rangers, and is that really somebody that you should be spending $2 million on at 32 years old?
No, I think, I think it goes against the model. Coppin has come in, he's signed a lot of young talent who you're signing for cheap, and you're going to hopefully have a couple of great seasons, sell for big. Kenny McLean, you're signing for $2 million, there's no resale value.
I could definitely get behind this move more if it was a free.
Yeah, again...
If it was a free... Then I'd be thinking, well, you know what? It adds depth to the squad. But I think if you're going to spend a few million, then there is better options out there, aren't there?
No, there is definite better options.
I think
you would
just be more excited if you signed a £2 million player from like a Croatian league or something, you know, some foreign league that you weren't aware of. When they signed Raskin, you would just... The unknown gives you a bit of hope. But Kenny McLean, you're thinking... All right, he's not the worst player, like, but he's not going to blow you away.
It screams lack of ambition. I'm sorry, if you're going to waste $2 million on Kenny McLean, why not pay the $3 million for Shanklin?
Totally different player, but sure, I get what you're saying.
Yo, I will not shut up until Lauren Shanklin's...
I know, but you can't just do that. Oh, if you're going to pay... Oh, they're going to get a goalkeeper to replace Butland, but if you're going to pay $2 million for this keeper, then why not just pay $3 for Shanklin? I mean, you need to drop the Shanklin shite.
No, I don't. Because $2 million for Kenny McLean...
$3 million's not enough, by the way. Hearts want mail.
Listen to this, right? See, signing Kenny McLean for $2 million, what's that do for Rangers' title hopes?
Bolster some, I guess.
Right.
Slightly.
They sign Shanklin for $3 million, what's that do for their title hopes?
It increases
does.
The chances of them winning it. Like,
you sign Kenny McLean, man... It's not a go for Joe. It's clinical depression for me. Kenny McLean, it's a no-go. I'll give it a 4 out of 10. As we said, if it was a free, it would make a bit more sense. But I think this is just a simple case of this guy being a Rangers man. The Euros are on. It's the journalists, it's the newspapers trying to make the rounds, trying to get people for the clicks. I don't think it'll happen. I'd be kind of shocked if it did happen. But we'll be here to cover it if it does happen. So until next time, leave your thoughts down below. And peace.